गुड आफ्टरनून क्लास 10 चिल्ड्रन. टुडे वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद द चैप्टर मैनेजिंग द अर्बन एनवायरनमेंट. एंड यू हैव टू कीप फ्यू थिंग्स इन माइंड. आई नो दैट एवरी टाइम वी कीप ऑन टेलिंग यू दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट बट चिल्ड्रन हियर द टॉपिक्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डू टुडे दीज आर विद द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ 5 marks. Basically, these questions, I mean, if you have prepared them for 5 marks and they are asked for 2, that's not a problem for you. So prepare these questions for 5 marks so that whenever they are asked even for 2 marks, you don't have any problem, right? But many a times these questions are asked in 5 marks. I have seen that. So you have to prepare them accordingly. I have made the video in involving all those points. They are written in the book too. It's just that I have fabricated them somehow so that they look more nicer, right? The first heading here, while managing the urban environment, what you have done till now is first of all discussing about urbanization, then the need of the hour was sustainable city, or the second eco city. Then we discussed the characteristics of eco city, then how we can improve the urban environment by discussing the energy, the transportation, shelter, and say zoning strategy, land use management, and so on. I mean, green buildings, that was also important, green buildings, features of green buildings. But after that, now ultimately things come on people. Government can make laws, right? Your administration can provide you facilities, but ultimately if we don't have the sense as community, as people, if we don't have sense to use it, if we don't know what is right for us, what is good for us and what's bad, the things are not going to change ever. It's basically the people's participation which is most effective to execute any program, right? This is something that we have to keep in mind, and that's why to conclude the chapter, the first thing that you are studying is community participation. How it is important, how it can play a vital role in environmental conservation, in improving the city improvement, or improving the status of the area. So in that case, first of all, because this is again a 2 marks question, what do you mean by community participation? Give one example. In that case, the definition says it is the first operative word is involvement of people. Community is people. So until and unless you say people are participating here, that's not going to be completed. So involvement of people. And it's not that one is worried about the energy and the other one is worried about deforestation and the third one is worried about the pollution levels and all, and then they are participating. No, because they have different interests, right? Community participation is when mass people, when many people, they get involved having the same goals and needs, like the people of one colony, if they are facing the problem of sewerage, and then they are supposed protesting for it, or they are moving to the administration for complaint, then, or they are doing it on their own, they for cleanliness they have come out and they are cleaning the roads and they are just managing up with the garbage and the waste disposal. So they are participating, they are putting their labor, right? Because their interest was same, all of them were facing the same problem. So here when we talk about community participation, that's the involvement of people having similar goals and needs. You may say sharing common interest in the decisions which may affect their lives. Suppose government is going to decide something for you. In that case, if people participate, then the decision would be more effective because people have a better know-how of their status, of their problems and their solution, possible solution. So community participation is a very important and effective tool in managing the environment, right? Then you come to the role of community in keeping the surroundings clean. This is a very tricky question, children. And understand that, you have to use your head here, okay? Your brain. You have to be slightly manipulative. This is class 10, so I expect that you can use your brains there. When you are talking about generally role of community in improving the environmental conditions, then your answers, your points could be generalized, which are applicable to all. But when you're talking about role of community in keeping the surroundings clean, so that means the area is specified now. The question is specified. How you can keep the surrounding clean? How what community does? How it can help in keeping the surroundings clean? And for that, you have to add up some more points. Rather, I would say in that case, those points should be used as the first, second, third, and fourth point. And just shift all these points slightly later. This is what you have to do. If your question is general, for anything community participation, if it has to play a role, what it can do, and then add up, if suppose the question is specified for cleanliness, in that case, you add up with the points which actually refer to cleanliness, right? You will be understanding when we will see towards the points. The first one here is a sense of, children, please make it clear, that sense of ownership, right? When community participates, I mean, if we are gathering together to resolve a problem in my colony, suppose. So I'm cleaning, suppose, the road which is present in front of my house. If I am taking care of it, this is something which builds up the attachment, which gives you the sense of ownership. And when you get attached, when you have that sense of belonging for something, in that case, you become more effective while taking care of it. So this is something which gives you a sense of ownership, and once you have that sense of ownership, you start taking much care of that particular area, right? Second thing is improved outcomes. Children, this is quite, general. It is a matter of common sense. There are 10 people protesting for something and 1,000 people protesting for something. So that makes the difference. Mass population, mass gathering is always effective. So understand that if many people have gathered together, they are participating in any kind of human welfare, in that case, it is going to give you more outputs comparatively when suppose 10 people are doing the same work, right? So improved outcomes are there when mass population is involved in any kind of human welfare program. When I say human welfare, environment is included there, right? Third one is improves the economy and living standards of the people due to sharing of the benefits. Children, when we say community participation, it is not only our side. It's not a unilateral movement. It's a bilateral movement. I mean, community participation in what? Community participation in the programs started by the government so that things can be executed more nicely. And for free, of course, like, so in social forestry, what did I teach you? In that case, I taught you that the people share the benefit and they will not work for free. Obviously, government has to allure them. Similarly here, when community is participating to enhance the execution of any governmental program for environmental betterment, so in that case, the benefits, the sharing of the benefit is there, and people, those who are in need of money, those who are poor, they share the benefits and their living standard improves, right? Then you go to the next point, that this is something where community participation is proved to be cost effective, because here you are not bringing the labor from outside. You are putting your own labor free of cost. That means you are not having any added expenses on the execution of any drive or any movement that you are participating in, right? So cost effective process, because people are putting their own labor rather than hiring the labor from outside, right? Another one is sharing of ideas. Now this is a very important point. Last 3-4 points, they actually impressed me a lot. When you talk about sharing of ideas, knowledge and innovation, if I am sitting alone and I am trying to do something like cleanliness drive or what, only one brain, only one creativity, only my ideas. But when it occurs like many people sitting together discussing on something, discussing on pros and cons of some advantages and disadvantages on some step, so in that case, the ideas and innovations can be, knowledge can be shared. And again, this is something which makes out a perfect outcome. Then you have better network to encourage social participation. More the people are there, more they are effective, more they are creating awareness among the people. So mass population, wherever it moves, it is more effective, right? Networking, I mean, suppose 10 people are there, they will be having a networking of suppose 1,000 people. But if 1,000 are there, they will be having a networking of, say, 1 lakh or 10 lakh people. So it depends. And second last one, that's critical awareness. Critical awareness means if you are, say, suggesting something, the other person, if has any idea, this is something where you can criticize if someone is putting an idea which is not practically feasible. In that case, the critic I mean, you can also play the role of the critic while participating as a community, right? And the last one is influence the decision making as per the needs, because you are participating along with the government in accomplishment of any task for the human welfare. In that case, because you are participating, you also have a say. It is not the government every time. Dictatorship is not there by the government to decide something like, okay, this is the Hitler rule. No. In that case, because you are participating, you also have a say. So you can influence the decision making too. Right, children? Now you come to if the things, these are the general points. You can always mention them, but from my side, if suppose the question is specifying cleanliness as per your syllabus, role of community participation is one point, and then participation in keeping the surrounding clean, right? So that's another thing. If this is specified, in that case, you see, children, please add up these points too. How community can keep the surroundings clean. See, it is like just starting a drive. I have seen when Swachh Bharat Abhiyan was started in India, many people, they came on the streets. I mean, they were collecting the garbage. Even your prime minister was doing so. So that was a thing where everyone was aware of, and that cleanliness importance. And then ultimately, this is a drive, cleanliness drive, for the waste disposal, organic waste separately, inorganic separately, how it has to be disposed, if vermicomposting can be done, sanitation things. Open defecation was criticized, and it was supposed to be stopped. The toilets, community toilets, that the provision of community toilets was also there. You can see I've written it here as well. And community, why involving community in this? Because they have a better know-how of the area. They need, suppose government say in this area only 100 community toilets are needed, but when you are involving community, they will tell you, no, 100 are not enough, you have to make 200, because people are more. This is the problem in a particular area, that's the problem in another area. So they have a better know-how, they are more connected to people because they are one of them, right? So there should be always a constant dialogue between the government and the community, so that their knowledge of the demands and needs about a particular thing can be become more effective, right? Then you have building up community toilets, stopping open defecation, keeping the surroundings clean, just separating the garbage as wet and dry garbage. Wet is organic and dry is inorganic. And composting the wet garbage into organic garbage, it should be allowed to undergo composting so that it can be disposed of, and we can also get the manure, right? Another thing is, apart from this, now I leave things on you. The ball is in your court. How you are going to answer this question? First of all, see what is the demand of the question. Is the more emphasis given generally on participation, or it is more emphasized to include community participation and cleanliness? So you use these points also and underline them. I have not underlined, but you underline them, right? And ultimately, it comes to sometimes Himani ma'am's favorite question. She tends to write, give one example. Explain the role of community in keeping the surrounding clean by giving one example. In that case, if it is from India, the best example comes as Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. People tend to write Chipko Andolan. Children, Chipko Andolan is for, that Chipko movement is for, indiscriminate cutting or felling of trees, right? It was to protect trees. Keeping the surrounding clean is all about the sanitation, garbage, waste. This is to be dealt with. So in that case, the examples, they include Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. I have pasted a picture, if you can see this one. You can see that this is a picture that I have pasted in my notes. See, and I just wish you people read this. Okay. This is just a case study I found on net. I found it good, and that's why I included it. Otherwise, if you have to give general examples of cleanliness, then in Lagos, Nigeria, there is a monthly cleanup day. People come on the street, they clean, they dispose of the waste, they just segregate the waste as dry and wet. They do everything. That's a monthly cleanup day, right? So another one is celebration of World Sanitation Day in Ghana and Nigeria too. Children, in India, like, we celebrate one Mahotsav, right? Similarly, they have the World Sanitation Day. And they do every possible, but that's not a matter of one day. Basically, we have to keep the I mean, we have to be aware of keeping the surroundings clean always, right? But these are just the examples. And then this is the case study. I only want you to read this case study. This is from Umtli village, Meghalaya, right? And this is, one of the examples from Swachh Bharat Abhiyan only. If you ever have to give the example, this could be the best thing you can do. I mean, take out the points from this case study that under Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, what did these people do to keep the surrounding clean, how they set a role model for others. Right, children? Here I am concluding with this video. One more in the next one. Okay. Thank you.